It is 5:46, and the Board of Commissioners' agenda-setting meeting is called to order on April 10th, 2018. Will the city clerk please call the roll?
Commissioner Hodges?
Here.
Commissioner Oakley?
Yes.
Commissioner Lister?
Here.
Vice Mayor Douthat?
Present.
Mayor Black?
Here. All right. I see we have a draft for the workshop agenda, and a number of things are already on here. I don't know if we need to discuss any of those, or...
Madam Mayor, if I may, in previous conversations with the board, there were some items that were proffered by the board for discussion. And there's some of those items that staff is requesting the ability to provide a staff report at the conclusion of any regularly scheduled board meeting, because some of them are just informational inquiries. For instance, the conversation that we've had with DOT about the sidewalk from Madeira Beach Fundamental to the Bay Pines, as well as the additional crosswalks on Gulf Boulevard. So there's some things that we can provide very quick updates and also provide memorandums that address some of the concerns the board has in a very simplistic and easy way. The workshop, some of the items that you see before you are more intensive in nature, that we need policy direction from the board as to how you wish to proceed. And so that's where we're trying to keep the workshop agenda between 4 to 7 items, but all those items are items that we need direction from the board so we can put forward a public policy recommendation for you to consider. So, and some of them are time sensitive, some of them are situations that are going to come again as part of the budget process. So I did want to let you know that they haven't fallen off the radar, what your inquiries are. Staff is going to address those, and those will be a part of a staff report that we will provide at the end of some of our board meetings.
Okay, very good. Excellent. I guess one thing I think we need to put on there, I don't think is on, is the kiosk. I'm not sure where that stands. Are we working on an RFP?
With the RFP, yes, I am currently drafting the RFP, and I will provide the board with a draft document that is going to be distributed out and actually hitting some of the highlights of some of the conversations that we've had with the board, obviously being a closed solicitation and similar to the current occupant that we do have in there. So your Chamber of Commerce, your informational type entities. We're also proceeding forward with making the improvements that were communicated to make sure that the structure is ADA compliant, but we are moving forward with the kiosk.
Okay, great. Do you know where then the art contest stands? Are we still considering that?
That is one item that we will provide in a staff report as far as the art contest.
That was kind of to be dropped until July, August timeframe, because we were going to do ours in the fall where Treasure Island's doing theirs in the spring.
Okay.
Okay.
Madam Mayor, if I may, if I could piggyback off of John's pass while you're down there, mm-hmm. There's two parking spots in the King's parking lot that have belong to the city of Madeira Beach from the get-go, and those signs get knocked down sometimes, and they don't
Which
know that.
Lot?
In Kings, the store right there, right next to the VFW.
Okay.
There's two spots right there that sign gets knocked down. We have a designated parking spot for our city vehicles, that nobody else can park in, and it's taking up one of the spots in the actual big parking lot. If we could just move our designated spot to that, then we wouldn't lose that spot all the time, because Kings, you know, people that shop at Kings park there, and I'm not sure if they pay Kings for those spots or not, but the two spots are ours.
I think they do. I think they're all like $5 or $10 a day.
There's a sign on the other parking spaces that are there, but not those two. So I just want to remind this commission that those are ours, and we need to make sure that the signage stays up, because we'll lose them, you know, through time.
Don't we own a third one there where because there's a resident who lives there?
We actually do, and we did find a provision in the code that stipulates that particular spot goes to the resident, is associated with the resident. So we did find the language, and kudos to our law enforcement team for finding that, because we had gotten some calls about that, but we have identified that there it is specified in the actual code.
Okay, great.
Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Also, in the past, in a couple of the meetings we've had, some residents have come up and asked about meetings and the times. Is this something that we can maybe discuss also, if we need to have two Board of Commission meetings instead of one, or change the time from 6 to 7, so it's more convenient for them to attend?
As part of the discussion that we'll have with the board this evening on your policies and procedures handbook, that was one of the discussions that we wanted to entertain with the board about the possibility of having two business meetings a month, especially during the peak season, and then probably go back to one meeting a month when we get into the summer months, which is more consistent of us focusing on the budget process, and that probably would be more conducive. But staff has been expressing to me that there is a substantial need for us to have two business meetings a month based on the nature of the things that are happening and how we have to respond a lot quicker than we used to. So, and the time, obviously, when we start workshops and when we start regular meetings, that's under the purview of the board, and that's been something that's been expressed to us from the public as well.
And the other one I had was the art contest. Has anyone picked that one? Oh, I already said art contest, I'm sorry. The yearly calendar. Has anyone picked up that since we don't have a staff group doing that?
Right now, we had a conversation with our IT contractor, and we're looking at some overhauls on our website. And then as part of the workshop that we did have with the board on a communications plan as well as a marketing plan, looking to incorporate that kind of document into the fold of things that we put out, because that's been a challenge for us, because there's events that are happening over at the pass, there's events that are happening at Archibald Parks, there's city-sponsored events, and then there's just events happening in our community. So we need to be able to have a calendar of city events as well as board of city commissioner meetings that somebody could either pick up a calendar, or they can download it online, or it's available on a mobile app or what have you. So we're looking at all that to be able to roll out here. I would hope in the next, probably in the next 30 days, we'll be at a point where all that information will be populated. I know the city clerk is working on a calendar for me to be able to put some things together as it relates to board meetings, workshops, when agenda packets are going to go out, the whole nine. So we're going to be putting together a master calendar internally, and then how we can distribute that out to the public so they're aware of what's going on in our community.
Okay.
I would like to have two things added. One is the FDOT just recently did a traffic study, and to discuss that, I think they did it in February at both the Johns Pass Bridge as well as the Tom Stewart Bridge here. And then talk about the possible use of a land use attorney.
Madam Mayor, if I may, currently we are in the process of, the city attorney has provided us some names for a land use attorney, a couple of names, and I'd like to work with the Planning and Zoning Department Director and the city attorney to shortlist a couple of the prospective individuals to assist us in some of the things that we have going on. But we are moving forward to secure a land use attorney to assist on looking at some of the development patterns and the items that we have going on. We can certainly talk about that at a workshop, or staff can proceed forward with getting that individual on board and then having them begin doing some of the work that we're asking them to do, looking at some of the development agreements, some of the proposals that we have in front of us as it relates to development, both on the town center side, but also future development opportunities here in the city of Madeira Beach. And then with the FDOT traffic study, we can easily provide that as part of a staff report or a workshop discussion. This particular workshop on April 24th is going to be pretty intense, but one of the things that staff is also going to be requesting is if it is the pleasure of the board to possibly have another workshop at the first part of May, because we want to talk to you about a prospective development that's going to be coming over at Johns Pass, and we wanted to get your perspective and comments on that particular project. before they move forward on the application side, because they're going to be requesting to enter into a PD with the city or a development agreement. So that's something that we wanted to have a meeting with the board first part of May.
Okay. Well, and I recommend, as long as it's all right with Commissioner Douthat, that is, we'll just wait till you, you know, get the land use attorney, and then we'll go from there. Is that okay with you?
Yeah. And our hope is that this is just the draft for the meeting on the 24th, but we want to provide you maybe 3 or 4 meetings in advance so you can see exactly where things are in the proverbial hopper, so you know that things are not falling off the radar, but they're on there, but we're trying to prioritize which items are sensitive to the agency. For instance, the 137th Avenue project, there's some changes with respect to the grant funding that we received from Swift Mud, and we thought it's pertinent to have that conversation with the board sooner because it may necessitate an additional conversation with Swift Mud concerning the 137th project. And then the board may request for staff to allocate funding for other roadway projects and initiatives if the public policy perspective changes based on staff's report.
Okay. All right, does anyone have anything else to add to the workshop? No? All right then. It's 5:57 and the workshop is adjourned.